Hi there, Doug Stewart with IT Creations with the HPE ProLiant ML30 Gen11 Tower Server. Offering enterprise-class performance, reliability, security, and a few other adjectives, the ML30 Gen11 is designed for small to medium-sized businesses, plus remote and branch offices, and those in need of an on-premise hybrid cloud solution. Like reading service guides and manuals? Then hit that subscribe button. Let's get started. This compact little nugget of goodness can easily support general office workloads with just a single Intel Xeon 6300 series or E2400 series processor with 48 cores. With that 14th generation processor, this system is definitely for entry-level workloads. But it can also be outfitted with a single double-wide performance GPU or two single-width 75-watt cards for computational acceleration or graphics applications. I will mention that once this system completes its primary mission and your business grows so large you need more office space and a server room, then this system can be rack mounted with an optional rack mount kit and cable management arm for continuous operation supporting your next level business goals. This platform includes a stylish security bezel with integrated lock that I have commented on before. Something about a first shooter game target, multi-level prison facility. Anyways, starting at the top of the chassis, two media bays can each be outfitted with SATA optical device, tape drive, or USB RDX docking station, which offers removable disk cartridges, also for backup, recovery, and archiving data. Below that, a small control panel that includes a USB 3.2 Gen1 port next to an ILO service port, then a few buttons and status LEDs, unit ID button, NIC status LED, health LED, and a power on button. Between those ports and the LEDs is a small knockout panel where an optional boot device can be installed. Are you interested in one of these little HPE ProLiant ML30 Gen11 server towers? I think for many of you, you're thinking, home server, because everyone needs one of those, right? Actually, this is a system that can be utilized for a number of enterprise business applications. It does have the credentials to support your business or host some interesting cat pics for home usage, maybe a little both. Reasonably priced and easily scales up, here's the deal. For a limited time, you can save up to $500 off a system that's listed or one that you can configure at IT Creations that's valued at $5,000 or more. Click that link for more information. And when you're ready to make a purchase, just mention this video. That boot device is a turnkey solution and includes two NVMe M.2 drives that are recognized by the management interface as a single drive, not a RAID controller. It only operates in RAID 1 for redundancy and cannot be configured to support other RAID options. The boot device isolates the OS, allowing the other upfront storage devices to be used for data storage exclusively. Below all that is the drive cage for either 2.5-inch or 3.5-inch SAS or SATA HDD or SSD drive types. The 3.5-inch chassis can be configured with up to 4 hot plug or non-hot plug storage devices. A 2.5-inch hot plug 8-bay drive cage can also be installed in that mid-chassis slot and offers hot plug storage devices. Around back, there are options for the PSU, either a single non-hot plug 350-watt non-redundant PSU or several flex slot options with one or two PSUs for redundancy. For that last option, either 500-watt, 800-watt, or 1,000-watt. I will also mention that if you do install a GPU on this system that requires a GPU cable kit, then the 350-watt Platinum ATX PSU is not an option. One of the selling points is the ability to share spare PSUs across multiple servers. Does that really happen? I mean, theoretically, I suppose. For security, there's an actual padlock loop which doubles to hold the front bezel key. Kensington security lock below that. There's actually another little slot inside the bezel right at the bottom to keep that extra bezel key. That seems kind of like keeping your spare house key in the house in case you get locked out instead of like hiding it under a rock or something. Below that, ports galore. If this was a Bond movie, I might say something different. There are 4 1 gigabit Ethernet RJ45 LAN ports on this system, that top one of which is shared with ILO. Since this is a single system that could support your entire SMB, remote or branch office, you're not going to waste that port on just remote management, if you don't have to. Then 4 USB 3.2 Gen 1 ports. Below all that, a VGA port, serial port, and then a DisplayPort 1.1A and dedicated ILO network port. Looks like you're not necessarily going to have to share that other LAN port. It comes embedded with ILO standard with intelligent provisioning, which does indeed allow you to access the system remotely using that integrated lights out port on the back of the system. HPE OneView standard, which is available for download, provides more tools for monitoring, inventory, alerting, and reporting of hardware, especially with HPE systems like Blade System, Apollo, and Superdome X. For accessing advanced ILO features, like the remote console and virtual media, you will need advanced licenses for both ILO and OneView, which can come bundled together. With remote console, your management capabilities are enhanced, along with the ability to troubleshoot remotely out of band. The side panel can be removed, loosening the thumb screw on the back. Inside, a plastic air baffle pulls air over the CPU and memory module slots using that rear-mounted system fan. Underneath the baffle, you can see the CPU has a heatsink with integrated fan pulling air, presumably from the front of the chassis, over the heatsink cooling fins and then out the back. Another optional fan in front at the base of the chassis is to keep the PCI slots cool, especially if you have a GPU installed, which do tend to add a bit of heat to the thermal equation. This system can be outfitted with an Intel Xeon 6300 series processor, which is part of Intel Xeon 6 line of processors with a P suffix. That P suffix indicates performance cores or P cores, not the efficiency or E cores. That said, what HPE seems to really be pushing on this system is the Intel Xeon E2400 series CPU, which is still fairly new as of 2025. That or they really haven't had a chance to update their documentation. With either CPU option, you have a choice of 4, 6, or 8 physical cores depending on the processor. Virtual threads are double the core count of the CPU thanks to Intel hyperthreading technology. These CPUs offer dual channel memory architecture and with 4 memory module slots, can support 2 DIMMs per channel. Full memory capacity for the system is 4 32 MB DDR5 UDIMM memory modules for up to 128 GB. Only unbuffered memory modules are supported on this system. Using 1 DIMM per channel will provide the fastest memory speeds at up to 4800 megatransfers per second. I will mention there is also a single Intel Pentium processor listed. There are 4 PCI slots on the motherboard. Starting from the top down, a PCI 5.0 by 16 slot with by 16 bus width, and then 3 PCI 4.0 by 8 slots, each with a by 8 bus width. The uppermost by 8 full height, full length slot is from the CPU. The other 2 full height half length slots on the bottom are from the PCH. For SAS drives, the system requires a storage controller, and there are options. An essential Gen 10 smart array controller or 3 Gen 11 tri-mode controllers. 2 of them offer full RAID options with data cache and require a capacitor. In the event of a power failure, the capacitor will power the system for up to 60 seconds to ensure cache data is successfully captured. There are a number of things you can install in those PCI slots, including additional network controllers with 1, 10, or 25 gigabit Ethernet. That PCI fan at the bottom front of the chassis and plastic baffle are optional but required when you install anything in the PCI slots. You can hook up a monitor using that display port on the back. You can also install a discrete GPU for accelerator and video output. The only GPU listed in the QuickSpecs is the NVIDIA RTX 4000 Ada with 20 gigabytes of GDDR6 memory. It's a single width card featuring Ada Lovelace architecture that uses a PCI 4.0 by 16 interface. I think that opens the door for a bunch more options at the lower end of the GPU list as this card has a TDP of 130 watts. You can definitely add an NVIDIA T4 or A2 to the system, but that's not going to solve any of your AI needs, if any exist. For hybrid cloud or on-premise workloads, you may have a need for the HPE ProLiant ML30 Gen 11 server tower. It offers enterprise-grade features tailored to the budget of a small business. Relatively expandable given its small size, this unit can support a number of common business workloads with ease. If you're still shopping, then check out IT Creations. We have this system and configure it to your specifications. I placed a few links below for you, or you can use that one right there. But don't worry, I created links in Bitly, so they won't be taken to any porn sites or anything nefarious. itcreations.com. Until next time, dear viewers, I'm Doug Stuman with IT Creations, and thanks for watching.